Dandelions, they're my favorite flowers. In the sunshine or during a shower, dandelions, they be popping up everywhere.
Great, thank you all for coming, and I'm sorry for the confusion about meeting at the archery range. I didn't know if people would be as vigorous as you all were to come, and so thank you for making the effort. And so come on around here, look at this. I think probably a lot of you know this one. We're gonna look at this wood sorrel here. And if you don't know this plant, this is a great one to taste. It'll go good with your spruce gum, I mean with your pine sap. Have anyone who hadn't tried it, make sure you have a taste of it. I think a lot of you might know this. Puts a little tang to that gum. Glad you asked. What causes that lemony sour quality? You know, this was probably the first plant that I learned when I was a little kid. I was out in the backyard with my dad. I was probably 5 or 6 years old. And he says, you know, you can eat that. I said, you can eat that? He says, yeah, we call that sour grass. I said, sour grass? He said, yeah. I think maybe that might have started me on my path. It's been downhill ever since. And just the idea that you taste that and it has that powerful sour smell taste. And later on, sometimes in the year, it puts out little seed pods, and they look like little okras, or at least I used to call them pickles. We used to eat them. It was fun. I showed my little boy that when he showed his friends, even his friends who wouldn't eat vegetables, they'd come out with a mouthful of it. And just in the idea that, you know, that you could reach out and touch these things and pick them yourself is so, so valuable to so many of us, particularly children. And you know, I don't know how many species you have here in the West, but even in the state where I live, North Carolina, there's like 13 species of wood sorrel, and they grow from the highest mountains down to the lowest swampy areas. I've seen them coming up in the sidewalks in Florida. I've seen them in San Diego. I've seen them, you know, out in the redwood forest, the great big redwood sorrel. And you know, one time I was walking in the woods back behind my cabin in North Carolina with a Chippewa Cree Indian friend that I had met through the storytelling circle. And this fella had been raised pretty traditionally up in the north. And I was asking him plants. You know, I had this no jive Indian in the woods. So I was asking him different plants. Well, he didn't know most of those plants because they were North Carolina plants. He was raised up in northern Saskatchewan. And then I came on a little wood sorrel. And I said, now how about this? Don't you know this one? Do you have anything like this up there? He goes, oh yeah. He said, I've gathered baskets full of that. I said, baskets full of that? What would you do with a basket full of wood sorrel? He said, well, if you're along the trail and you're picking various wild greens to make a salad with, he says, you know, you don't have any salad dressing with you. You get a bunch of these sour leaves, you chop them up. It's almost like as if you put you know, vinegar on your salad. I said, oh, that's great. I said, what do you call this plant? And he said, we call it Kasigatawasoskia. Whereupon my next question would be, how would you translate that word? And, you know, he'd never had to translate that word. I could see him kind of working it out. Kasiatawasosi. He says, it means it's all there. He says, I wonder why we call it that. He kind of shrugged. We walked down the trail a little bit. And a little bit later, he comes and says, oh, I know why we call it it's all there. We consider six to be a representation of completeness, the six directions. North, south, east, west, sky, and earth. That represents totality to us. Well, you look at this plant, it only has three leaves. So you think it's incomplete. But then you look, and of course, each of those three leaves is divided into two, so the six is there. And he says, and we call that plant, it's all there. And we think that reminds us and teaches us that if we just look deeply enough within if we look deeply enough within ourselves and in the natural world, we realize that we are complete beings. And that's what that plant is there to teach us. I thought, that's what that plant is there to teach us? What's that one there to teach us? And what's that one there to teach us? And of course, that's why we're here. We're trying to understand. You know, we're not really raised in a culture where every being that shares the earth with us is known and assumed to have a story or a teaching or a lesson. But it kind of reminds us that we can just open our heart or squint our eye or whatever it takes to realize that probably the answer to every question we have is here within the natural world, which we're a part of. And that's, I guess, our mission here in life, you know. And besides that, it tastes good too, doesn't it? Mm. Yeah. And so what is that sour? So that sour, this plant named oxalis, was when they started to look at the constituents in it, and they found an acid in it. Since they found it in the oxalis plant, they called it oxalic acid. And so that's the same acid that's in rhubarb, that gives rhubarb its tang. Same thing that's in some of the sorrels, the French sorrel. And they say that if you get too much oxalic acid, it can work with calcium balance in your body. So it's often suggested to eat it in moderation. And so there you go.
My favorite flowers in the sunshine during a shower. Dandelions, they be popping up everywhere.